again? Why don't you give up? Don't waste your time in these jungles. Go back and enjoy the luxuries of your palace.
I will not rest, Betal, until I've kept my word. So come with me, or else.
All right. Have it your way. But you know my conditions? You will have to listen to a story during our journey and not utter a single word, or I'll fly back to my abode. King Samarjit ruled the kingdom of Malaidi. Being the king and eligible bachelor, his matchmaker Ram Gopal visited him often with countless proposals.
Your Majesty, there are many proposals for you, but this time I have a unique one and I'm very eager to present it, if I have your permission.
Go ahead, Ram Gopal. Speak what you have to say.
Your Majesty, there is a merchant, Chandramani. He has a daughter, Manimala.
So, be clear, Ram Gopal.
Your Majesty, Manimala is the most beautiful girl I've ever seen. Her beauty and grace is matchless. And I feel she would just be a perfect queen of Maladeep and your wife.
All right, let me inquire about her. Thank you.
It's my pleasure. I shall take your leave now, Your Majesty.
Called us, Your Majesty?
Oh yes. I want both of you to go to Merchant Chandramani's house, meet his daughter Manimala, and find out how suitable is she to be my wife. Then report back to me.
Yes, Your Majesty.
Isn't Manimala so beautiful?
Yes, you are right. But would she be suitable for our king?
Yes, why not? But why do you ask? You have any doubts?
Actually, Manimala is so beautiful that our king will always be occupied with her charm. And then ultimately it is our kingdom that will suffer.
I think you are right. If the king marries her, he will neglect our state in her company. So what shall we do?
I think we should hide the truth for the betterment of the kingdom. Your Majesty, we didn't find her attractive at all. In fact, quite ordinary. We do not think she is fit to be your wife.
All right. Now you may go and don't mention it to anyone.
Yes, Your Majesty.
That lady on the roof.
Your Majesty, she is the wife of the courtier Krishnanan. She is a merchant's daughter.
What is the name of that merchant?
Chandramani, Your Majesty.
Your Majesty, we didn't find her attractive at all. In fact, quite ordinary.
Your Majesty, courtier Krishnanand is seeking permission to see you.
Krishnanand? Send him in. Yes, Krishnanand. Tell me, what brings you here?
Your Majesty, I have learned from one of the ministers that you like Manimala. Your Majesty, I'm your servant and I'm willing to leave her if...
Stop it, Krishnanand. How dare you think that I will agree to such a proposal? She is your wife and you should protect her. How can I commit such a sin by marrying someone else's wife? I don't want to punish you for saying this, but now go away or else I will change my mind. You liars! Why did you lie about Manimala to me?
We agree that we lied. But we thought if Manimala became our queen, then you would always be busy in her company and neglect the matters of the state.
So, in the interest of the kingdom, we decided to lie to you, Your Majesty.
You two have committed a serious crime and shall be hanged for it.
Now tell me, Vikram, who committed a crime? Answer my question or I will break your head into pieces.
It was not the job of the maids to think what is right or wrong for the kingdom. They should have done what was told to them, but lied in the interest of the kingdom and the king. But the king was harsh in giving capital punishment to the maids just because he could not marry Manimala. His crime was bigger.
Well said, Vikram. You are wise, but foolish. And forgetful. You spoke and you broke your word. So here I go.
You cannot escape me, Betal. I shall get you.